found that people they are architects, but you try to act too like activists. You try to act like citizens who live in a precise place and who try to act in their neighborhood. So you started in 2001 with a project called Eco Box, which developed step by step different way to create a collective device for, it was in a very poor area in north of Paris. And so we discovered together how to create collective involvement with people from different cultural backgrounds. This is a real problem in metropolitan area, because by jumping here in Totmorden, the people is from the same culture. They are all with the same religions, more of them, etc. So the condition is not at all the same in big cities. So how to do with these very different people, very different social conditions, etc. So we learn a lot about that with this project. And another specificity of our project, in the first one, it was a project developed in temporary locations, because there are very few land available in big cities, because they have a big economical and speculative value. So starting from nothing, it was very difficult to have lands to do that. So we try to develop project in temporary locations, but to stay temporary, to stay unsustainable. So in order to obtain sustainable project, you try to create an approach in which the device could be relocated. So we developed a nomadic project with temporary and mobile devices, including a library, a collective library, including a mobile media lab, including a mobile garden too. So it's very difficult to imagine how to be that possible. And by this project, we try to create, to recreate some behavior from forgotten behavior from people in urban condition. It's aiming to be able to reappropriate the proximity space, to be able to work together, and to involve in the life of the city, because more of them, they expect from the state. This is a result of the welfare state condition. So people, they expect, they are very expectative. They are critics, but they do nothing. So this project, it was a real good experience, a learning experience for us too. And we started to manage a series of temporary spaces, and after more and more they was co-managed by us with different residents for different activities, gardening, screening, local market, local economy, etc. And after 2006, we started a new project in another part in Paris, and this project continued to be run by the residents. So it's what we call a self-managed space. And this is very important, because usually, so I repeat what I said before, nobody don't try to give this responsibility. They prefer to be users, but not responsible, not owners. So how to create that? So after this project in 2006, we started a new project in east of Paris called Passage 66. It was another very different condition. This time it was a very small space. The first project, it was a huge space, 3,000 square meters. So for Paris, it's really a huge and a real opportunity. This one, it was just 200 square meters in a former passage. It was blocked by a new building, and in a very dense area. This was a former passage blocked by a new building, so on the fences. and the class considered to be invisible because they are window in both walls, lateral walls. And the city decided to fence it, and more of the residents, they bring the trash. They throw all the trash by the window. And so they asked us if it's possible to do something, but with very few money, and with not really a client, because it was a risky process, a risky project. Nobody was volunteer to be the owner if the city was named by us. And so we tried to discover clients, to discover users. It was an area not really known by us. And we tried to discuss with the people with different occasions. This was with a flea market occasion. So we tried to discover what they want to do in this in the larger area, what they are able to do, which they have competencies, etc. And with this collection of desire, of competencies, etc., we try to imagine a project. And starting with this year, we're starting to use the space with nothing, just first by cleaning the space with volunteers, and after by using with fine objects or objects used by different people, even. And with very informal and spontaneous activity, like collective tea, something like that. It was really a collection of people and objects in a very diverse cultural area in every dance. And in this way, you started to know people from the neighborhood to be like residents, because you have a very and to create connections, to create choosing, to verify which thing could be supported by the neighborhood, because the space is very striking. They are just 6.5 meters, so it was how nobody don't want to be owner, because it was a big risk of conflict between our activity and the neighborhood. And step by step, all the people, they started to appreciate the space, to use the space, and together with them to draw out a project. And decided with them to have a small garden somewhere here in a more sunny area with a dry toilet and a rainwater collector and another compost from the garden, vegetables. And we try to build in the street side of the site a small cabanon, because it discovered to be possible to build in a smaller area. And this cabanon the idea it was to be used for the winter activity, for a small workshop with kids, to keep seeds, to keep tools, to be used like in space for concerts and etc. And important too, the city was used just in a spontaneous way in 2006 in order to see what is possible to be done. And after that, the construction site, it was for a long year, because it was a former activity too for the young people unemployed to come, because of learning in construction. And it was a risk to lose this dynamics created in 2006 in this period. So you keep the work construction site open to public every week in order to keep the dynamics. And actually, you create a series of closed ecological circuits locally. You collect the rainwater, but you are not connected to the public evacuation water system. So the water is very, very well controlled, the consumption is really minimal, exactly what you need. So the collective compost, all the people, they know how to do. And step by step, this is the young people who build. They are the older ones, who build some parts, the initiate, the few stages to construct the garden with residents and volunteers. Some parties organized in this year of the construction site, in the construction site. Other debates or political moment. Recycling parts of the building, a concept in the construction site, the image starting of the garden, some parties in the garden, the fish plots, some meetings, discussions, open doors, recycling materials, and the roof, green roof. The compost, the toilet, the dry toilet, the responsible dry toilet, the closed circuit, and the ground floor of the space could be completely open to the street with the semi-pedestrian street in which some young groups, they have very difficult attitude, so they organize rodeos, if you know it, motorcycle and sometimes with cars, and it's really dangerous. So if I get all this collective initiative and uses, they start to be open to the public space and to to reintroduce collective use in the public space and in the neighborhood space. So it's an ecological corridor too, in a very tiny space, so it's just 6 meters and a half. Sometimes people, they enter for the stage this time, after some years, and they ask us, but it's larger than before? Because I remember some images from the beginning that the space is really small. And all these people, because they know each other from some years, like Anne-Marie, because she's here with us, step by step they are more and more in charge, like us, and recently they create a non-profit organization in order to manage the space, because they know to use very well, like us, all the ecological devices, so the compost, the toilet, etc. And you have a vegetable delivery, sometimes you organize the picnics, I don't know if you can do. So the place starts to be like a hub. And what is for us really amazing, I know Anne-Marie, she lives in a tower just near, I don't know, 50 meters far from the place, in a tower with 30 levels, so it's a big tower. And they contact the owner of the tower and they reclaim space around the tower and they start a new project like this one just by themselves. So actually they run 56, 53, 59 and 61. And it's what we call a rhizomatic dynamic. So they have all the information about how to do by themselves. So they continue just because they want, because they believe to be important. I don't know. Is it a very different question? I can move the image. Coucotte Fessage. Why, if you want to ask her, because she don't want to say nothing, but you can to ask maybe Anne-Marie what she likes, what she don't like.
Peut-être je viens toutes les semaines maintenant, que je pour rencontrer des gens, pour jardiner, pour mettre organiser des projets, des animations, que j'apporte mon compost deux, trois fois par semaine.
So she's coming every week now to do something that I
have. Two or three times, maybe.
Two or three times she's bringing the compost. But she's organizing a lot of the work in the space as well as proposing new projects. Can you give some examples?
They organize a teacher, local teacher with some members. Because another member, she write a text about the space, like the Georges Perec collection about the space, and they decide to create like a teacher event. It was really unusual.
Poésie. Place des voisins, fête des voisins.
Lots of with the direct labor. So this is the new use of the, so from time to time you try to go out in the public space. And
il faut dire que c'est un petit peu privé, c'est public et privé puisque chaque adhérent a une clé pour entrer dans cet endroit.
So the space is in the same time public and public and private because they have keys, so they are actually around 40 keys. In fact, there are much more users because some of them they come for vegetables. So there are around 100 users to use the space every week by computer autonomous. And they redesigned the garden in order to have in the same two possibility to have individual plots or collective plots.
Semi-plots.
And you try to go quickly. So actually, you try to develop a new project called Urban. We started this project in 2008. The idea is just to do something maybe more complex and more to involve better and more the people, because in this kind of project like 56 and other one initiated by before, the people they come in the free time for gardening, for spring, for the days like here, and after they return home in a very standard flat, Parisian flat, and in the morning they work in the same neoliberal economy and it's collapsing. So the idea of Urban was to develop new place to work in a different way and more equitable and non-profit way, to develop other way to live together in a cooperative and ecological way, to develop urban agriculture more and local culture production, and to try to create networks between these complementary urban functions in order to create closer ecological circuits, but not just ecological, economical, too, social ones and other ones, and to open these local circuits to larger scale. I can use this water.
Oh yeah, carry on.
So the idea is in our European cities, because you have a big heritage, agricultural heritage, it's very difficult to have big areas. So the idea is to find different small areas, interstitial areas, to be connected by this kind of ecological, economical, social, cultural networks, and to create exchanges between them, using old buildings, empty space, etc. And so we study different situations with different kinds of interventions, and we study in a very scientific way to try to to do a simulation about what you are able to obtain ecologically, economically, etc., using three or four species who have together 2,000 square meters. So for these 2,000 square meters, our simulation tells us to be able to reduce more like 60% of the water for rain, for the garden, for cleaning, etc. So you are able to reuse all the vegetables, of course, trash in the proximity garden or big garden in Suburbia. So we develop different simulation for different kind of closed circuit, resources, jobs, cultural ones. And what is new in that is this, it's something you call transversality between closed circuits. By example, if you go to Bedzet, if you visit Bedzet, it's very nice, but if you are hungry because it's a long trip, they don't have a restaurant or nothing to eat. And if you want to buy some books about energy, etc., they don't have a bookshop. So, because a lot of people go to Bedzet, they have a very big potentiality to develop other economical activity or knowledge activity, etc., but they don't do. So in our project, we try to pass from one motivation from one closed circuit to another one, from ecology to economy, from economy to social, etc. So this is the idea of Urban, and we try to develop resilience in European cities and with residents. This is important, very important too, because by our former projects, so pilots, one is for ecological cooperative housing, another one is for ethic economy oriented to recycling in order to produce eco-construction parks dedicated to the neighborhood. And the last one is for agriculture, urban agriculture and green pedagogy. So, and we are in contact with the only ethical and ecological bank in France, so we plan over a state company in order to develop other, a cooperative state company in order to develop other projects in other space and other lands around Paris. And you are in contact with other partners of us from Spain, from Berlin, from England, etc. So the Urban could be to a movement, transversal movement in Europe. Because it's very necessary in our city today. Sorry for my English, but I can't prepare it.